Hi, everybody. Welcome to another Customer Power BI session at the Microsoft Business Application Summit. My name is Lauren Faber, and I'm a member of the Power BI Customer Advisory Team. And I'm very excited to have Vikas with us from Standard Bank today. Standard Bank was able to present last year at MBAS, and I'm super excited to be able to see what they've achieved in just a year. So, Vikas, if we could start by having you go over the agenda for today, a little bit more about Standard Bank and what your role is at the company.
Hello, thank you for giving us the opportunity to showcase our Power BI journey. It's always an honor to present at MBAS. As you've mentioned, we had the privilege to present at last year's MBAS, and I will only recap the start of our Power BI journey. We'll also discuss something that we as a team are very excited about, BI Plus. And then just the next steps on how we actually onboard our users to our environment. So my name is Vikas Kleinans. I'm the Power BI platform owner for the Standard Bank Group. I'm responsible for Power BI and our BI platforms in Africa. I've been with Standard Bank for 6 years now, and I have over 10 years of experience in business intelligence. Standard Bank is a financial institution that offers banking and financial services to individuals, businesses, institutions, and corporations throughout Africa and abroad. Standard Bank is the largest banking group by assets in Africa. We have a rich 157-year history in South Africa, and we started building a franchise in sub-Saharan Africa almost 30 years ago now. The ICBC is Standard Bank's biggest shareholder with a stake of 20.1%. Africa is our home. We drive our growth.
Perfect. Thank you so much for that intro, Vikas. And now if you could go over a little bit more of what was presented last year with the original BI challenge.
We are a team of only 12 members supporting over 20,000 users across the world. So as you can imagine, these 12 members supporting the BI community needs to be SMEs in their fields. Our main responsibilities are focusing on aspects like stability, security, licensing, research and development, as well as expert guidance to ensure that the platforms perform optimally. We ensure that there's a solid platform strategies in place and to create an easy-to-use, efficient, and all-round pleasant experience for our users. We spend a lot of time and effort on the stability of our platforms, making sure the platform is secure and we are sufficiently and correctly licensed. We believe that if these three pillars aren't in place, users won't actually make use of our platform. And we won't have time to get to the part that everybody loves, to do research and development. We won't be able to assist our customers with the required expert knowledge as well. In order for us to implement our core strategies, we actually needed to implement the following building blocks to ensure that Power BI is properly scaled, it is stable, it is always available, the right level of governance has been applied, and the on-prem gateways are in place. We actually covered most of this in our presentation last year, and I'll only just summarize what we're trying to show in this slide. From the start of our Power BI journey at the end of 2017, we did a lot of legwork up front to make sure that our platforms are up and running and that it is stable. Some of this has been to improve the monitoring, for example, on the BI usage. Our BI analytics data warehouse is something that we're very proud of, and it provides us with insights on how each individual user, cost center, business unit, and country are using our platforms to ensure we plan effectively. We can show exactly what BI assets each user touches in our organization. We create a lot of alerting, even on our mobile devices, to know if something went wrong. We can even kill or start services and processes using our mobile phones on an in-house developed app called Z-App. We focus predominantly on user adoption and having ensured that a functional foundation and clearly defined processes are in place. It is now an easy and seamless process to onboard new users to our platform. At the end of 2019 and beginning of 2020, we made a conscious decision to start focusing on the value-added features available, and the uptake has been incredible. With a combination of a solid foundation and since the rollout of BI Plus, our user adoption has more than doubled between April 2019 and April 2020. Power BI is now used in 20 countries. We have over 8,000 dashboards, almost 14,000 users, 2,500 workspaces on the premium capacity, and over 10,000 reports. This has not been an overnight success, but a gradual process to get everything in place.
Yeah, that's really amazing to see the growth that has been able to happen just even within a year's time. And it's neat to be able to see that you establish that foundation and you have that in a solid place where now you're able to move forward and take your BI to the next level. So earlier in the presentation, you mentioned something called BI Plus, and just barely you mentioned it briefly again as well. What exactly does that mean, BI Plus?
Okay, so we get asked that question a lot. So what exactly is BI Plus? We see BI, it's a term that we coined for every value-adding feature of a BI platform. BI Plus focuses on the more modern BI techniques that are currently available. Many business users are only aware of the more traditional reporting mechanisms, and this is because they were using traditional reporting tools until recently. As they are onboarded onto the more modern BI platforms, we need to make them aware of these new features available. Cognitive AI traditionally would have been done by a group of data scientists to build these machine learning models or cognitive features using Python or R. But today, companies like Microsoft have made this part of their BI suite. So because this has been made part of the BI suite, users no longer require the deep mathematical and statistical knowledge needed to be able to implement these features. We started masterclasses to train our users on using these features and showcasing the ease of use of implementing more advanced features as part of their reporting solutions. And once they understand the value add of this and how much better decisions they can make on their data, that in turn drives adoption of the BI tool. So we get a bigger increase on users on our platforms. Everybody in today's world are concerned with AI and data science, and this is an easy gateway to access these. So now let's take an example of smart alerts. Users don't have to go and look at their dashboards every day to see if a certain event has occurred. It can now be triggered using Power Apps, for example, or a feature within Power BI can trigger an alert on their mobile devices when a certain event in the data happens. We've enabled users to access the data on any smart device, no matter where they are. Users can also embed the reports in other applications like SharePoint and Microsoft Teams. Microsoft Teams especially enables business to effectively collaborate, share content, and what we see is developing a knowledge portal where business can create a one-stop shop for all the reporting requirements. They can host meetings, they can share documents, create a wiki on required processes within a business unit, and then, especially in today's working environment, have a platform where you can just say good morning, even when you're not working, even when you are working as apart as a team. You can also use NLP, natural language processing, for example. Users don't even have to write one single line of code to create a dashboard. Once a data model has been developed for them by the technical team, they can now create the dashboard that suits their needs by using the language that they're most comfortable with. I will also show you a demo on what I mean by this a little bit later. Forecasting, AutoML, machine learning, those are all new concepts that business isn't aware of, and now we are showcasing them either by classes or by creating POCs for them so they can see the value add. No longer do business users have a backwards-looking view of their data, but a forward-looking view of their data. There are a lot of additional features that we also showcase, things like key influences, forecasting, decomposition tree. It is all tools that are available to assist business to actually make better decisions. And all of this are concepts that we have then coined BI Plus.
Yeah, that makes a lot of sense when you explain it that way and show that it's every value add that you have to your BI platform. You also mentioned that you have prepared a demo to show us today. Could we dive into that?
Okay, yes. So basically what we show our users, as soon as our customers approach us, they're normally either apprehensive to try anything new or they're more or less content on using their current solution and not keen to move to a new platform. What is mostly recurring theme is business saying they aren't technical enough to create a report themselves, they aren't familiar with any AI concepts, and they won't be able to use these advanced features. So this demo will showcase for them what is possible. They don't need to be a data scientist to actually use these features. So as long as you understand your data, you can build a meaningful report. And we've deliberately made sure that this demo is under 5 minutes to actually show them you can build a dashboard in less than 5 minutes. So without further ado, let's move over to that demo. Okay, so to start off, we're going to create a couple of KPIs and then dragging the widgets to the top of the dashboard. We build these KPIs, like I said, by only asking our data questions and not writing any fancy code. So firstly, we did total sales, we drag it to the top. Next, we do the profit. Power BI automatically sums it for you. Just drag it to the top, make it look pretty. And then next up, I want to show the number of products. Again, Power BI does everything for you. You just ask it, or you're just asking your data a question. Next, I would like to see the top three salesperson. So Power BI intuitively picks up and provides suggestions for you while you type. You also have the option to create a different visualization if you don't want the visualization that Power BI provides for you. But Power BI intuitively creates a visualization that suits your data or the data type. So an example of how to create a visualization of the one that you want. So show me the sales by using a linear graph. And you can do that. And Power BI actually intuitively chose that one for you. So next we create a visualization that all business users love to see. And that is by plotting your sales on a geo map. So when you use geolocations, Power BI has the capability to automatically plot it on a map for you. We did this one by postal code, but you can type in if you use the country name, if you use a city, if you use a province, Power BI can actually intuitively create that on a map for you without you plotting on where those geolocations are. So next up, I want to see, show me all the products for each state. So again, Power BI chooses the visualization for you. It creates a bar chart that you can also change if you wanted to. So you move that to the right bottom corner just to make it more visually appealing, everything sorted. If you hover over these bars, it actually pops up a little tooltip for you with the number of products, with the name of the state. And these tooltips are also customizable, and they're actually very customizable. That's a great feature. So next up, we're actually going to start using some additional AI features and apply insights to try and explain the fluctuations in this visual. So again, this is all done in the background for you. It gives you a whole list of insights into your data. And if you want to use one of these visuals, you just click on it and it adds it to your dashboard. You don't have to export the data or ask a data scientist to develop a model for you to analyze the data. Everything is built in and ready to use. So we can also go back to a chart that we created earlier, this line chart with the sales by year, and analyze what the decrease for the sales between 2015 and 2016 is. What's nice about it is actually automatically picks up if it's an increase or a decrease. And again, it's going to do all the hard work in the background without you writing any code or doing anything on your end. So again, there's a lot of different graphs that you can choose from if you don't like the first one that's given to you. And you can also add that graph to your dashboard if you wanted to. There's also the nice feature at the top, you'll see the thumbs up and the thumbs down. So you can actually provide some feedback to the Power BI project program managers So on the usefulness of these visualizations. We're going to add that one to the graph now, to the dashboard. So there's different types of graphs and visuals that you can add to your dashboard. So that's how easy it actually to add, to create one page of a dashboard on your data. This was done in less than 3 minutes. So next up, we're going to add some additional features. I want to add one more page of something that I actually like. You're going to struggle to do on your own if you don't understand the logic behind it. So I actually want to see all the factors that affect items being returned. So for that, I'm going to use the key influences visualization. So first up, you select the column that you want to analyze, and then you move fields that you think of might influence the rating into the explain by field. You can use the key influence tab to assess each factor individually, or you can click on the top segments tab to see how a combination of factors affects the metrics that you're analyzing. Like you saw, if I click on one of those bubbles, it actually drills down into the segment to give me an explanation of the values. And that is building a dashboard in less than 5 minutes.
You make it look so easy. I love that demo. It really makes it seem undaunting to be able to create a dashboard and to be able to use Power BI. So thank you for that. So you've come a long way in a year. You have people who are starting to really adopt Power BI. You've been able to create this BI Plus. So you're on this really good path, but what does that mean is next for the journey with BI at Standard Bank?
Okay, so after that usually after showcasing this demo, business is normally very impressed. They want to know how do they get onto this, how did they start using Power BI, and then also when will these features be available. So what's great is we can tell them everything that they saw is available right now. It's available immediately. That's usually when they get very, very excited. They want to get stuck in straight away and want to know what are the next steps, what's the cost, et cetera, et cetera. So normally what we do is we suggest running a small masterclass on their data and showing them what's possible. And then we also advise them to maybe do some self-paced online training or register for classroom-based training. We add them to our team site. We've created a team site that we've also had in our presentation last year. There's a vast amount of training material in there, interesting articles. We've got a very active Power BI community of over 2,000 users. And everything that they might need is in there to actually start using Power BI. We are looking at, especially now, maybe doing some more online instructor-led training by our Center of Excellence, where we can maybe do the dashboard in a day, dashboard in an hour, whatever, maybe some modeling training. We have also the next phase in our Power BI journey is our rollout into the rest of Africa. So that's us in a nutshell. And perfect. To be continued.
Yeah, perfect. Thank you so much. Do you have any last things that you want to add before we end?
No, we appreciate all the assistance we get from you guys, especially the program managers. They're always open and eager to help.
Oh, thank you. Well, glad to have you here. Thanks, Vikas.
Thanks, Lauren. Appreciate it.